Lunch Menu.
Elementary and middle school breakfast grilled cheese sandwich and assorted Pop-Tarts. Elementary and middle school lunch top and go beef nachos. High school chicken bites or pork chops plus the pizza line every day. Lunch Menu brought to you by First Franklin Financial in the shopping center between Walmart and Goodwill. Lunch Menu.
Save on your Labor Day grocery needs by shopping the super hot Labor Day sale at your Jessup Piggly Wiggly. On sale to the pig, fresh lean ground chuck, just $1.99 a pound. Fresh Boston butt pork roast, 99 cents a pound. Fresh chicken leg quarters, only 49 cents a pound. And fresh green peanuts, a low 99 cents a pound. Shop for these and many, many more Labor Day specials at Piggly Wiggly on West Cherry Street in Jessup.
You only get one chance to make a first impression. When you look at your home, what do you see? I'm Kristen Kennedy.
And I'm Gloria Overholt.
And we are your Jessup Team Duckworth Realtors. Let us tell you what we see in your home so that you can make that first impression sell.
Come see us today at our office located in the Overholt Building or give us a call at 912-262-0366 and ask for your Jessup Duckworth agents, Gloria and Kristen.
Tradition. Excellence. Do you bleed blue? Hail Southern, the home of champions.
To the 20, to the 10, did he do it? He did! Wings up, Eagle Nation! Touchdown, Georgia Southern!
Hear every game right here on the Georgia Southern Sports Network.
Your station for Georgia Southern Eagle football, WISO 105.5 FM.
It's time to take an adventure. Splash into family fun from mild to wild at Wild Adventures Theme Park in Valdosta. This Labor Day weekend, September 1st through the 3rd, is your last chance to splash at Splash Island Water Park featuring the new Ohana Bay Toddler Park. Bring the whole family for one more fun-filled weekend before Splash Island closes for the season. All Labor Day weekend, bring a food donation for Second Harvest of South Georgia and get buy one, get one free admission. Start planning your adventure now at wildadventures.com.
Local news on WIFO.
It's time now for a look, ladies and gentlemen, local news. In the news, the election date not until November the 6th, but as of today, four of the five commission candidates will have a write-in candidate against them in the Wayne County Commission races. Only candidate this time unopposed is Commissioner Ralph Hickox in District 5. In District 1, incumbent Herschel Harris now has opposition from both Michael Gillian and Grady Thomas. In District 2, Kevin McCrary, who appeared on Thursday's Butch and Bob show, is running against longtime incumbent Jerry Shag Wright as a writing candidate. In District 3, incumbent Mike Roberts already had a Democratic opponent, Kenny Teston. On Thursday, Freddie Coley registered as a writing candidate in District 3. And in District 4, the second long-term Commissioner James Thomas now has a writing candidate against him, Pastor Michael Swint, who at the third public hearing asked to hear from both Commissioner Wright and Commissioner Thomas since they had been serving the longest on the commission board, but the hearing that they simply got out of hand never did address the issue or have much to say at the public hearing. Again, Michael Swint now running against James Thomas in November. All this, the fallout of a Monday night vote of 3-2 to raise the millage by 5 mils, and all this following Monday night's third public hearing where it was revealed that the administrator threatened the auditor, requesting a letter stating a 5 mil increase was needed. Kel Harris at the meeting Monday night, and when directly asked by the chairman, Herschel Harris, was he threatened? The answer was a resounding yes. Also Monday night at the end of the meeting, Ralph Hickox wanted to make a motion, which he was not given the opportunity to do so. The meeting adjourned. Hickox, after the meeting, stated he wanted to make a motion to cap the budget at $20 million. That topic on the county's Thursday night agenda. 3-2 vote has to raise the millage at 5 mils has caused this firestorm. People were simply upset. People were angry. People were still looking for answers to questions. People on the phone asking these people to run for political office. Commissioner Ralph Hickox looking to ask the ACCG to come to Wayne County to help give solutions to the financial issue. Again, simply a lot of frustration at the three public hearings. Here's just one person's comments. Longtime Wayne County resident and politician Warren Purvis had these comments at the first public hearing.
Never would I.
You know, this is a hard meeting to come to as a taxpayer. I had the privilege to serve just like you people have. And I know you have some tough decisions. I don't know who your auditing firm is, or if they notified you about the indebtedness that we have. If they did, and they just did it, or why did you wait so long to bring it out? if this thing, it didn't happen overnight. It's been drug out. And I'm embarrassed. I'm hurt for you. And it's a sad thing for this county to be in the situation that we're in. Now, I could stand up here and throw rocks at you, and you could throw them back at me, and we would have differences. But the end line is this county is in one hell of a mess, and you are at the helm. You are the ones that put us there. And if you want to deny that, then you can deny it. But we are in a ditch, and we got to come out. Now, I don't know what it's going to take for you people to bond together and to get you some advice to get you out of this hole. But I don't like paying for your mistakes, and the rest of the taxpayers don't like that either. I am totally in awe about this whole situation, and it worried me to death enough to come up here and to say something about it. My wife said, "Don't you go up there and show your butt about the thing." and I don't intend to. I'm just telling you, the ox is in the ditch, and we got to get him out. Yes. And the burden is on you. And it shouldn't be on us. It shouldn't be pushed back to the taxpayers for the mistakes that you all have made. Thank you.
And again, those comments are one person. The first public hearing and the first of three. Commissioners are set to meet Thursday due to Labor Day weekend and Monday being a holiday. The agenda is Commissioner Ralph Hickox has on the agenda under items with the commissioners discussion about a budget cap. Also on the agenda to consider and approve the ACCG to come to Wayne County and look at the revenues and expenses. Under items with the county administrator, it's listed financial review. At the three public hearings, the commissioners and the administrator claim they have a plan to solve the financial issue, but Commissioner Ralph Hickox at the third public hearing simply stated there is no plan. The bottom line is that this financial crisis did not happen overnight, but unfortunately was not revealed until after a county retreat on Jekyll Island, in which the commission praised their administrator for laying out the financial picture to them and explained to them why he was recommending the 5 mils. Statement was made that hopefully in time they will be able to lower the millage rate once the problem is solved, which one lady told them her fear is that when you raise the millage and get more tax money, it hardly ever turns the other way. Case in point being the tax, case in point being the tax anticipation note, the money that the county borrows every year in order to function during the course of the year. For a period of 3 years, the Board of Commissioners worked hard to lower that amount borrowed. It went from $5 million to $4.5 million, the next year down to $4 million in 2017. And then what happened in 2018, this board administrator voted to raise it to $6.7 million, which they claim is a line credit and has not been used in its entirety. But they stated Monday night that almost $2 million of it has been used, and they state they're currently using that line of credit to make payroll. Ralph Hickox says TANS is a dirty word. It's something the Board of Education stays clear of, and the cities of Jessup, Odom, and Scriven governments also do not use. Yes, the county's in a financial crisis. The board's voted 5 mil increase by a 3-2 vote. Once again, the reaction has been anything but positive. Now with the election set for November the 6th, each commissioner, with the exception of Ralph Hickox, has a writing candidate running against it. We'll be back with more news after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
It's fall and changes in the air. Whether it's the season turning a little cooler, the kids growing a little older, heading back to school, or your family growing a little bigger or smaller, change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. We believe in helping all our members preserve their resources, even offering Rocky Raccoon accounts for kids to help your children learn the true value of a dollar. AFCU is your trusted financial advisor. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes, this fall and every season after. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Lutawisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, preserving our resources. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Harris Ace Hardware, Wayne County's favorite hardware and building supply dealer, will not be undersold and will match any competitor's price on the exact item. On sale at Harris Ace, get a Stanley retractable utility knife, regular price $9.99. It's now only $3.99 with the Ace Rewards card. And don't forget, Harris Ace is your place for X-Mart Moores, Traeger Grills, Yeti Coolers, Costa Del Mar Sunglasses, and your hometown Yellowwood Pressure Treated Dealer. Harris Ace Hardware on West Cherry Street in Jessup.
When you have an accident, you, not the insurance company, chooses the body shop, and you only need one estimate. All you have to do is call Jerome Riles at B&C Collision Center in downtown Scriven to deal with the adjusters and insurance company. Whether it's a little ding or a major crash, that B&C Collision Center across from Wasden Cabinet Shop in Scriven, deal with the insurance company so you don't have to. Call them at 579-2274. That's 579-2274.
Wayne County's hired a new chief tax appraiser. The announcement came late Thursday afternoon. The new appraiser is Byron F. Johns, who's worked for the Glenn County Board of Assessors since 2010. Johns, one of eight people who applied for the opening position here in Wayne County. Board Chairman Harry Thompson states that of the eight, Johns was the most qualified. Thompson says the board's very excited that Mr. Johns' appointment will be the beginning of a great future and a great relationship for Mr. Johns of Wayne County. Mr. Johns, currently resident of Waynesville, Georgia, and hired Thursday as Wayne County's new chief tax appraiser. This is Labor Day weekend. The Georgia DOT says they're suspending interstate highway construction-related lane closures from noon today until 5 a.m. Tuesday, September 4th. Lane closures will also be limited on major state routes that directly serve key tourist and recreation centers. Georgia DOT State Construction Engineer John Hancock says Labor Day weekend is approaching. We expect heavy traffic statewide as vacation travelers take to the roadways for a final summer trip. Hancock says they're limiting construction and lane closures to make travel to gas lakes. Lane closures make travel to Georgia's lakes, parks, and tourist attractions easier and safer for all. As we mentioned, the county commissioner's agenda is out for Thursday, September 6 to 7 p.m. Under presentations and announcements, Mike Mitchell with Republic Services presenting Satilla Riverkeepers with a donation. Under old business, no items listed. Under new business, Blake Tillery on hand to talk about the discussion of opioid litigation. Consider and approve the tax adjustments and corrections from the Board of Assessors, and consider and approve the ACCG to come in and look at revenues and expenses. Two board appointments still on the agenda, Wayne County DFAX Board in District 5 and Wayne County Board of Assessors in District 5. Under items with County Administrator Financial Review, County Commissioner's items, Ralph Hickox talk about a budget cap. There is an executive session on the agenda, and it's all set for Thursday night, 7 o'clock, at the County Commissioner's meeting room. We'll come back with some final news notes after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
It's fall and changes in the air. Whether it's the season turning a little cooler, the kids growing a little older, heading back to school, or your family growing a little bigger or smaller, change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. We believe in helping all our members preserve their resources, even offering Rocky Raccoon accounts for kids to help your children learn the true value of a dollar. AFCU is your trusted financial advisor. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes, this fall and every season after. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Lutawisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, preserving our resources. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Morton Collision is located at 1320 West Pine Street in Jessup. Morton's offers free estimates, 23-hour towing, and they guarantee their work. Call 427-3769 or after hours, 912-294-6140. The staff at Morton Collision Center works with all insurance companies. So for guaranteed work with a qualified staff, go to Morton Collision at 1320 West Pine Street in Jessup. Morton Collision, quality you can see.
At Country Financial, we're more than just an office you may pass by as you drive through town. We're a part of your community and help support the programs that make our neighborhood thrive. We take the time to get to know our customers. We know that every situation is unique, and our goal is to understand yours so we can help you be confident about your financial security and your future. Call me, Sean O'Quinn, your local Country Financial representative today to talk about how we can help ensure that the future you're dreaming of is something you can proudly own no matter what it looks like. My number is 588-1051.
Final notes in the news. Once the Labor Day holiday is over, the Board of Education's push for the continuation of the ESPLOS will begin. Superintendent Jay Brinson and the board believe that the registered voters will see the need for the continuation of the penny tax for education. If passed in November, it will generate approximately $17 million over a five-year period. The board has outlined in a referendum where the money will be spent. The majority, approximately $11 million of that $17 million, will be used to renovate and remodernization of James E. Bacon Elementary, provide air conditioning to the Old Nest Gymnasium. Other projects include purchase of air-conditioned buses, technology equipment, and money for a new track. With the county tax bills arriving in the mail before the November vote, there is a concern that the $5 million increase could have a negative effect on the East Ploss vote. Only time will tell. Superintendent Jay Brinson says the key for him and the board is to simply make certain that all the registered voters have the correct information. He believes the East Ploss will pass in November. Also coming up on the ballot in November for City of Jessup residents will be the question and issue of Sunday alcohol sales. Two questions for the voters in November, one to allow alcohol sales in restaurants on Sundays, such as Angel's Fine Dining and Alex Sports Bar and Grill, to name a few. Second question on the ballot will be to allow Sunday alcohol sales in convenience stores and grocery stores like Harvey's and Piggly Wiggly. City of Jessup stresses that it will be two separate questions on the ballot and two separate issues. A voter can vote yes on both or no on both, or can vote yes for one and no on the other. But both questions will be on the City of Jessup residents' ballot come November. 3 weeks of early voting before Tuesday, November 6th, which is election date. Wayne County also able to vote in all the statewide races, which are heating up and being hotly contested. Latest polling in the governor's race between Stacey Abrams and Brian Kemp have a virtual tie heading into the Labor Day weekend. As always, we encourage all registered voters to take the time to get out and vote. Enjoy your Labor Day weekend. That's going to do it for the latest in local news. Sports comes your way in a few minutes. We'll preview the big high school football game tonight as Richmond Hill comes to town. Packed high as expected. And that's going to do it for the latest in local news. Bob Morgan saying have a great day.
You've been listening to local news on WIFO.
Totally transparent car buying. With Neesmith Chevrolet Buick GMC Live Market Pricing, know for certain you're buying at the low market price. We constantly monitor multiple auto and competitor websites to always offer the most aggressive market prices. No games, no gimmicks, no kidding. That's why Neesmith Chevrolet Buick GMC is the home of the no-hassle deal. Skip the runaround and discover the difference of truly transparent buying on every new and pre-owned vehicle every day. We're online just like you, and we continuously scan pricing on hundreds of vehicles to update prices in real time. At Neesmith Chevrolet Buick GMC, know for certain that our live market price is the low market price. Experience a new and totally transparent way to buy with live market pricing. Chevy, find new roads.
Good morning, everyone. We have made it to the holiday weekend. Our Friday forecast is going to be mostly sunny. Temperatures today climbing into the upper 80s and low 90s with partly cloudy skies tonight. Tomorrow will be partly cloudy with a slight chance of a shower or storm. Temperatures close to 90. And on Sunday, more clouds moving in, a 50% chance of showers and storms and a high near 90. I'm Georgia meteorologist Laura Huckabee in the GNN Weather Center.
Whether it's a car accident, storm damage, or a fire, when the unthinkable happens, it doesn't matter if you saved money in 15 minutes. In this moment, it doesn't matter if your neighbor has the same insurance you do. In this moment, what matters is that your independent insurance agent and the company that stands behind them have you covered. Auto Owners Insurance, the no-problem people. Call Rachel Carter, Dana Davis, Lynetta Baxley, Anna Pickren, Ron Cobb, or Jimmy Swain at James M. Swain & Associates Incorporated in Baxley, Georgia, or Cobb & Swain Insurance Agency in Hazelhurst, Georgia today at 912-367-3601 or 912-375-2520.
Insects can rob your trees, shrubs, lawns, and flowers of vital nutrients. Fertilome makes several products to help control pests effectively, and they're available at Wayne Feed and Seed in Jessup. The knowledgeable folks at Wayne Feed and Seed can help you select the correct Fertilome product to help you control insects. There are several to choose from, including tree and shrub systemic, insect drench, and fruit tree spray. Fertilome insecticides, fungicides, medicides, and other products are found at Wayne Feed and Seed, 712 West Cherry Street in Jessup.
Do you need a new lawnmower? If so, head to Knight Saw Company in Baxley. Choose from a large selection of name brand mowers. Knight Saw Company offers the best lawnmowers at the best prices anywhere. They also have in stock belts, batteries, and parts for all mowers, along with name brand trimmers, blowers, and hedge trimmers. For over 50 years, Wayne Countyans have been getting their power lawn equipment and parts from Knight. Knight Saw Company on the Jessup side of Baxley on Highway 341. Here's your menu in the Wayne County School System for Friday, August 31st.
Lunch. Lunch menu.
Elementary and middle school breakfast, grilled cheese sandwich, and assorted Pop-Tarts. Elementary and middle school lunch, top-and-go beef nachos. High school, chicken bites or pork chops, plus the pizza line every day. Lunch menu brought to you by First Franklin Financial in the shopping center between Walmart and Goodwill.
Lunch menu.
WIFO-FM, Big Dog Country. Time to check your birthdays and anniversaries. Brought to you today by Bardrin Power Sports. We are going all the way through Monday today because of the Labor Day holiday. We won't be here. So on Monday, September 3rd, happy birthday to Sadie Forbes, 1 year old on Monday. Happy first birthday to our beautiful and sweet Sadie. We love you so much. Uncle Jody, Aunt Katrina, Jacob, and Emma wishing Sadie Forbes happy first birthday on Monday. Tomorrow, Aurora Wilson, 1 year old as well. Aurora Wilson won on Saturday. From Mimi and Papa, Grandma Jeff and John wishing Aurora Wilson happy first birthday tomorrow. Faye Woods, happy birthday. Faye Woods from your Wayne Memorial Volunteer Family. Faye Woods on Monday, Memorial Day, Labor Day. For Faye Woods from your Wayne Memorial Volunteer Family, Faye Woods on Monday. Logan Collins, happy 8th birthday, Logan. We love you with love from Daddy, Miss Shelley, Avery, Uncle Jamie, Aunt Candy, and Grayson. Logan Collins, 8 years old. Happy 8th birthday, Logan Collins. Happy birthday to, on Sunday, September 2nd, to Hugh Armstrong. Love Carla, Caroline, Tripp, and Kate. Hugh Armstrong celebrating on Sunday. Happy birthday, Hugh Armstrong. Love Carla, Caroline, Tripp, and Kate. More wishes for Logan Collins. Happy 8th birthday, Logan, from Jamie, Candy, and Grayson for Logan Collins. Also wishes for Logan with love from Daddy, Miss Shelley, Avery, Uncle Jamie, Aunt Candy, and Grayson for Logan Collins, 8 years old. The happy big 5-0 to John Westbury from your daughter, and I love you, John Westbury, 50, from your daughter with love for John Westbury. Also wishes for John Westbury, 50, from Jeff. Hope you have a good one. John Westbury from Jeff. Hope you have a good one. Also, happy birthday to John Westbury, Daddy, from Alyssa and Alexis. We love you, old man. John Westbury, 50 today. Also wishes for John from Mama and love you. John Westbury is 50. Robin Eubanks' list for the 31st. Melissa Dooms celebrating. Melissa Dooms celebrating. Tanya Drury, birthday wishes Tanya Drury. Alex Hall is on the list as well. Alex Hall. Barbara McGee. Barbara McGee celebrating. James Maudlin. James Maudlin. James Sellers on the list. James Sellers. Happy birthday, Joseph Strickland. Joseph Strickland. William Tyre, birthday wishes William Tyre. And Kayla Wilson. Kayla Wilson, that's the Robin Eubanks list. On Saturday, happy, happy birthday to Jill Phillips. We hope you have the best day. Love the Sluder girls. Jill Phillips is celebrating on Saturday. Happy birthday to Jill Phillips. Long County calendar this morning. On the 31st, Lydia Golden. Birthday wishes to Lydia Golden. Happy anniversary to Jim and Sheila Fuller. Jim and Sheila Fuller, happy anniversary. And Harris Boyd celebrating. Harris Boyd, happy birthday. That is today. Looking on September's page, Beth Boyd. Beth Boyd tomorrow. Beth Boyd. Sunday, Jocelyn Dasher. Jocelyn Dasher, Dasher celebrating. Then on Labor Day, it's Robert Popple. Robert Popple celebrating. Robert Popple, happy birthday. That is the Long County calendar this morning. Big Dog birthday book today. Laurie Thibodeau, 39. Happy 39th birthday to Laurie Thibodeau from Mom, Dad, Rosie. Engaged with love for Laurie Thibodeau. Laurie Thibodeau is 39. Text OSOs at 912-427-3711 this morning. Happy 5-0 to John Westbury. Love the Landons for John Westbury, 50, from the Landons today. Happy birthday to Hall Long on Sunday. Hall Long from Aunt Carrie, Uncle J.R., Harper, and Ryder for Haley Long. Haley Long on Sunday from Aunt Carrie, Uncle J.R., Harper, and Ryder. Happy birthday, John Westbury, from Pam and Joey Lusher. Pam and Joey Lusher wishing John Westbury. Happy birthday to John Westbury. Okay, we did John Westbury from the Landons. Happy birthday to Joni Hutchison Monday from Dwayne and Sam. Joey Hutchison Monday from Dwayne and Sam for Joey Hutchison from Dwayne and Sam. Happy 10th birthday, Haley Long from Mimi. Haley Long 10. Happy 10th birthday, Haley Long from Mimi. Or Haley Long from Mimi this morning. Happy birthday to Dr. Hugh Armstrong from Aunt Vi. Happy birthday, Hugh Armstrong from Aunt Vi today. Happy birthday to Rhonda Yeomans. Rhonda Yeomans, John Westbury, and Karen Lee. On Saturday, Wayne Mullins, Laura Nichols, Deliza Vasquez. On Sunday, Sheila Hill, Mike McKenzie, Lisa Agnilla, Hugh Armstrong. All of those from Joey Smiles Photography this morning. Happy birthday, Jamie Lewis from Shelley, Dylan, and Nick. We love you bunches. Jamie Lewis from Shelley, Dylan, and Nick. We love you bunches. We'd like to wish a very special sweet 16 to Haley Driggers from Mama, Daddy, and Cole. We love you. Haley Driggers from Mama, Daddy, and Cole with love today. 912-427-3711. Birthdays, anniversaries brought to you by Barger and Power Sports. You've got time to shoot one in right now via text. We'll get to that before we're done today. Happy, happy birthday, Marvin DeLoach on Saturday. Marvin DeLoach on Saturday. And reminder, we're going through Monday, so if you've got a Monday birthday, now is the time to do that. Happy birthday on Saturday to our wonderful sister, Jill Phillips. Jill Phillips, love Kay and Nell on Saturday. Jill Phillips from Kay and Nell. Happy birthday to Bill Tyer Jr., Bill Tyer Jr., and Rhonda Yeomans from Kay and Ray for Bill Tyer Jr. and Rhonda Yeomans. Happy birthday, Rhonda Anderson-Jones from Bill and Barbara. Rhonda Anderson-Jones from Bill and Barbara today. We would like to wish Billy and Amy Stipe a very happy anniversary today. Love Gaga and Papa Bill for Billy and Amy Stipe. Happy anniversary, Billy and Amy Stipe today. Happy birthday to Kendrick Stevens, 15, from your sister Kennedy. Kendrick Stevens, 15, from your sister Kennedy. Happy birthday to Kobe Williams. Kobe Williams is 17, from your sisters Kenijah and Monique, and your godmother, Kobe Williams, 17 today, from your sisters, Kenijah, Monique, and your godmother. Okay, comment. What is this here? All right, we did the Jill Phillips from Kay and Nell. Let us scroll down and make sure we get all of these cleared out here. Happy birthday, Jamie Lewis from Shelley, Dylan, and Nick. We love you bunches. All right, what is this? Okay, these are other questions and comments here. They're buried way down there. 912-427-3711. Birthdays, anniversaries on WIFO, as always, brought to you by Barger and Power Sports. Thanks for waking up with the big dog at 737.
Famous birthdays today. Actor Chris Tucker is 47.
Yes! What's wrong with you? Just spin your car. Every 5 minutes, there's something, a bomb or something. I'm leaving.
Singer Debbie Gibson is 48. And comedian Buddy Hackett was born in 1924.
Why is it? What? When people are around you, they start talking like you. All your friends, as soon as you're around, they say, you know who's coming over is Buddy Hackett. All of a sudden.
See, I don't talk that way. I'm talking like them.
All right, you've got 30 seconds to get one in via text at 912-427-3711. We'll come back with your Big Dog Country Birthday Cake winner. We'll do that right after this for Bargeman Power Sports.
Bargeman Power Sports invites everyone to come visit their unbelievable new showroom on Highway 301 South in Jessup and on Highway 341 in Brunswick. They have a great selection of ATVs, golf carts, mowers, and more. Bargeman Power Sports carries Arctic Cat four-wheelers and side-by-sides, the new popular Can-Am four-wheelers and side-by-sides, cruise carts, and Yamaha golf carts. Bargeman's has the full line of Kimco scooters. Don't forget, Bargeman Power Sports offers a complete service department for all your service and repair needs. Stop by today and check out Bargeman Power Sports, Highway 301 South in Jessup, and their new location on Highway 341 next to I-95 in Brunswick.
Your Big Dog Country Birthday Cake winners on this Friday morning. Logan Collins is 8, and Haley Long is 10, and they pick up the cake. One each from the Jessup Piggly Wiggly Bakery. Certificate here at the station. You come by, you pick that up, you head to the pig and claim your prize. Bardron Power Sports brings you birthdays, anniversaries. Brunswick, Jessup online, BardronPowerSports.com. We're wishing Logan Collins happy 8th birthday and Haley Long, 10 years old, Big Dog Country birthday cake winners here on WIFO-FM. At 7:40, we've got so much more to bring you between now and the top of the hour. Local sports with Bob Morgan. We'll check in with state news from GNN, a look at your weather forecast, and so much more on this Football Friday, Labor Day weekend. Good morning from the Big Dog.
Happy birthday.
Logan Collins, 8. Haley Long, 10. They are the winners from the Jessup Piggly Wiggly Bakery. At 7:39, good morning from WIFO-FM. Let's get a look at your GNN Weather Center forecast.
Good morning, everyone. We have made it to the holiday weekend. Our Friday forecast is going to be mostly sunny. Temperatures today climbing into the upper 80s and low 90s with partly cloudy skies tonight. Tomorrow will be partly cloudy with a slight chance of a shower or storm. Temperatures close to 90. And on Sunday, more clouds moving in, a 50% chance of showers and storms and a high near 90. I'm Georgia meteorologist Laura Huckabee in the GNN Weather Center.
River level is at 6.8 feet, 6.8 falling river level. We've got a high tide at 11:59, 6.9 feet. Low this evening at 6:22. Sunset is at 7:52. Temperatures upper 60s, low 70s. Right now, 70 here at the Big Dog WIFO. Your GNN Weather Center forecast on FM 105.5.
Save on your Labor Day grocery needs by shopping the super hot Labor Day sale at your Jessup Piggly Wiggly. On sale to the pig, fresh lean ground chuck, just $1.99 a pound. Fresh Boston butt pork roast, 99 cents a pound. Fresh chicken leg quarters, only 49 cents a pound. And fresh green peanuts, a low 99 cents a pound. Shop for these and many, many more Labor Day specials at Piggly Wiggly on West Cherry Street in Jessup.
Brands you know and trust from people you know and trust. Magic Mattress and Home Furniture in their new location in the shopping plaza next to Walmart. Now with home furnishings to complete your home with the same great quality and service you've grown accustomed to. So when you buy mattress sets, add your bedroom furniture, living room furniture, and dining room furniture. If you don't see what you're looking for, let Glenn or Chelsea know and they'll get it for you. Magic Mattress and Home Furniture, 114 Allison Street in Jessup. Call 912-256-REST. That's 912-256-7378.
At 7:42, it's time for state news from GNN, brought to you by England's Mobile Glass and England's Collision Center.
England's Collision Center and Mobile Glass. You know a good feeling is when you pick up your car satisfied. England's Collision Center and Mobile Glass, serving our community for over 20 years for all your collision and windshield needs. England's Collision Center, located at 586 Southwest Broad Street, 912-588-9922.
I'm Matt Cook with the Georgia News Network. Hartsfield-Jackson Airport tired of security breaches on the tarmacs and runways of the airport, so they're taking another security step. They're adding concertina wire to the top of a number of fences around the airport. Twice this summer, people climbed the fences and got into the area where the runways are. The added security with the new razor wire will cost the airport about $5 million. They say the project's adding about 450 feet of the wire every day to the perimeter fence. Residents in Spalding County on alert after what may have been two attempted child abductions in their area. In both cases, the people involved were driving a white van. Both happened this week, with someone in the van approaching a child trying to coax the child away. In both cases, other adults intervened. Police aren't sure if the two cases are linked, but it is a possibility. Big Labor Day weekend coming up, especially in Atlanta. The city of Atlanta is expecting an influx of over 700,000 people this weekend for things like the Falcons, which played last night, Dragon Con, a Black Gay Pride event today, Dragon Con, a Lynyrd Skynyrd concert, and Georgia Tech football on Saturday, and of course, Dragon Con. Lots of variety. Atlanta police are ready.
We're going ahead and cancel off days for Saturday and Sunday to make sure that we have adequate resources for all these events.
That from CBS 46. Like I mentioned, Dragon Con is underway in Atlanta. Depending on how you look at that, it's one of the weirder or one of the cooler things that happens in the city of Atlanta every year. Spokesman Dan Carroll talked with GNN affiliate WDAK in Columbus.
It's the largest fan event in the world that features film, comics, television, gaming, music, art, and so, so much more.
Tens of thousands are all costumed up for the event, and it started yesterday. Continuing news updates from around your state, I'm Matt Cook with the Georgia News Network.
FM 105.5.
Fall is a great time to be on the
FM 105.5 WIFO. Good morning from the Big Dog at 7:45 on this Friday morning. It is Labor Day weekend.
It's Friday!
Finally here, the last hurrah of unofficial summer is over tonight and this weekend. Wayne County, Richmond Hill coming your way tonight. We'll have that for you with the Coach's Show starting at 6:30, pregame at 7. Bob and Joe from Donaldson Mattery Field, JC Stadium at 7:30 tonight here on FM 105.5 WIFO. Let's zoom in on the Sportscape webcam and see what Bob is up to. Looks like he's typing, so there must be some last-minute additions to the sportscast coming up next on WIFO. But right now, time for the Family Minute with Mark Merrill. That's brought to you by Wayne Obstetrics and Gynecology.
Dr. Harris and the staff of Wayne Obstetrics and Gynecology want to wish the Wayne County Yellow Jackets the best this season. Dr. Jeffrey Harris offers comprehensive care for women in Jessup, Wayne County, and the neighboring areas. He is board certified in obstetrics, gynecology, and family practice. Dr. Harris offers health care to women in any stage of life. Call them at 530-7301. That's 530-7301. Go Jackets!
How do you let your teenagers go but still keep them safe? I'm Mark Merrill with today's Family Minute. Giving teens room to grow while guarding them is a balancing act, but there are some things you simply must know about your teen's friends. First, get to know them. Learn about their friends by having them over to your house. You'll learn a lot through casual conversation. Second, get to know their parents. Introduce yourself to them and try to discern whether they have the same parenting mindset. Third, get to know the details of where your teen and their friends are going, who else will be there, and what they'll be doing. Then, when your teen comes home, be there and be available just in case they want to open up and talk. Remember, your family first.
For more resources on today's topic, go to markmerrill.com. Family tips, great insight, and a sneak peek into Mark's life as a husband, father, and leader. The Family Minute with Mark Merrill, helping families love well.
Seasons change. Quality of service does it. For 75 years, First Franklin Financial has been serving the financial needs of your friends and neighbors. You can always depend on the caring staff to be there when you need them. Drop by and see your friendly Franklin folks at 1074 North Macon Street, or give them a call at 427-4237 or apply online at 1ffc.com.
All loans are subject to our liberal credit policy and limitations, if any. First Franklin Financial Corporation, NMLSR number 141654. Georgia Residential Mortgage License number 5656.
When further treatment is no longer an option, hospice can provide services to manage symptoms and difficulties caused by illness, emotional, psychosocial, and spiritual care, as well as support to the families and caregivers are all part of hospice care. Hospice of South Georgia has been a part of the health community in Wayne and surrounding counties since 1998. The professional yet compassionate attention provided by our staff is unsurpassed. Widely supported by donations from the local population, Hospice of South Georgia is the local nonprofit hospice in Wayne County. Our administrative office is located at 1625 Sunset Boulevard, and Hospice of South Georgia accepts anyone who meets hospice criteria, regardless of their ability to pay. Please call 912-588-0080 to speak with someone about hospice care. That was 912-588-0080. We are your hometown hospice, and we are here to serve you. Hospice of South Georgia. Working to add life to your days.
Smart Physical Therapy in Jessup has moved. They're now located at 360 Peachtree Street next door to Wayne Family Practice. Smart Physical Therapy specializes in manual therapy to reduce pain in your joints, as well as advanced strengthening for surgical and non-surgical conditions. Among other manual therapy treatments, they also offer dry needling. If you have any questions, call or come by anytime. Smart Physical Therapy offers free consultations. When you're in the need for therapy, see Garrett Pye or Nick Childs at Smart Physical Therapy. Give them a call at 559-20 559-2071, or go by and see them in their new office at 360 Peachtree Street, across the street from Dr. Spinola and Dr. Hendricks. They're next door to Wayne Family Practice behind the Jessup Hospital. And remember, it's your choice on where you want to have therapy. Choose Smart Physical Therapy in Jessup. Call them at 559-2071. 559-2071. Smart Physical Therapy, 360 Peachtree Street in Jessup.